Hi, I'm Ray Burkett with the Anesthesia Department at Cullman Regional Medical Center. I'm one of the nurse anesthetists here. I want to talk to you today about the anesthesia you'll receive for your joint replacement surgery. Here, when we plan your anesthesia, we'll bring you in the morning of surgery. We'll do an extensive evaluation of your past medical history and your current physical status. And once we obtain all of that information, we'll talk about your anesthesia. There are different types of anesthesia that we provide. The anesthesia that we do or like to provide is mainly centered around your comfort during surgery and for the number of hours after surgery that you will be with us. So the type that we prefer, the type of anesthesia, is a regional block or a spinal block with ultrasound guided injections of medicine that can provide you not only with anesthesia throughout the surgical period, but also for quite a number of hours after surgery is over with. Now, don't be alarmed. You won't be awake for the entire time that you're in surgery. We do keep our patients constantly sedated. Most patients never recall what happens or don't even have any recollection of having conversations or things like that. But you can rest assured that during the surgery, you'll be very comfortable, probably completely sedated. Afterwards, when surgery is over with, you go to recovery room. You'll be there for about 45 minutes to an hour, and then up to your room for the rest of the night. As you remember, I mentioned that you would be staying with us overnight and on for a few days. We want to make sure that we can provide you with some comfort, especially during the initial 24 hours of post-operative period. We do that with a couple of different techniques. The spinal block I mentioned before can provide you with a number of hours of pain relief after surgery, but in order to extend that period of time, we can do one of two things. We can insert catheters into an epidural space in your back, much like pregnant women when they have their babies. We can insert those types of catheters. We can leave those in for up to 24 hours and provide pain relief through automatic infusion pumps through that catheter. Also, we can perform ultrasound-guided blocks into the affected limb that you're having surgery on, and those blocks can give you up to 24 hours of pain relief as well. But nevertheless, the whole goal is to keep you comfortable throughout your entire surgery and during the post-operative period. Our primary goal while you're here is to keep you comfortable and relaxed throughout the entire anesthesia process, the entire surgical process. We'll answer all of your questions before we take you back to surgery, and that includes your family as well. We'll give you realistic expectations on what time frames you can look at and how long surgeries will last. But we'll be with you not only through the surgery, into recovery room, and all throughout your post-operative stay.
Hello, my name is Tasha, and I am one of the nurses on our post-surgical floor 3 East. I'm going to be walking you through some of the things to expect after arriving to your room from PACU. You will be probably coming back with oxygen. We will be working with respiratory to help you get weaned off of that. Another thing to expect is that we'll start you out with clear liquids and slowly advance your diet as tolerated. You'll also be placed on a monitor to make sure that we can keep up with your blood pressure, heart rate, respirations, as well as your oxygen. These monitors will stay on for at least 24 hours, and depending on the pain medications, may stay on longer. Your pain medications will be based on what the doctor orders. You may come up to the floor with an epidural that will come out within 24 hours, or you may have a PCA pump that will go to your IV and give you medications based on how often you press it. You will also have, after the DC of either the epidural or PCA, medications that you can have by mouth or IV as needed. Depending on your surgery, you may come back with a drain. There are several different types of drain. The most common is a Stryker drain. Depending on how much output you have within the first 4 hours, your blood may be reinfused. We'll monitor your labs, and depending on those, you may or may not have to have blood during your hospital stay. When you arrive back to the floor, you may have a Foley catheter. Those come out either the first or second day post-op. You will also have either a compression device or TED hose, as well as oral blood thinners or maybe a Lovenox shot, depending on your doctor's orders. Thank you for choosing CRMC.
Good morning. My name is Deb Alverson. I'm one of the therapists here at the hospital. For you patients having a total knee, we will come to the recovery room and put a CPM machine on your knee that begins bending it, and you'll use the machine during your stay here at the hospital. If you are having a total hip, you may come out of surgery with a wedge between your legs. There are certain things that you cannot do when you have a total hip, like bend over and pick up an item out of the floor. We will also have an occupational therapist come and work with you and issue a breacher and a bathing sponge for you to use at home. The first time up, you will be evaluated by a physical therapist. They will bring an exercise book to your room and review the exercises with you and get you up. You will use a walker during your stay here at the hospital. You will have physical therapy twice a day, even if you are here on the weekends. We will also teach you how to climb the stairs so you are able to get into your home at discharge. If you would like to bring pajamas or shorts and shirt to wear during your stay here, that would be great. If you would also like to bring tennis shoes or house shoes, that is acceptable also. Thank you for choosing CRMC.
I'm Suzanne King, registered dietitian here at Coleman Regional Medical Center. The handout you've been given in pre-admission testing are basic guidelines of what we would like for you to follow as far as your diet after while you're recovering and recouping from your joint replacement. This is not, let me repeat, not a diet, but more or less guidelines on what we'd like you to eat. You'll notice the first thing is vegetables. We like to see you eating about 2.5 cups of vegetables per day. These can be fresh, frozen, canned, whatever you have access to. Fruits, we like to see you doing 2 cups of fruit or 2 to 3 pieces per day. Once again, those can be fresh, frozen, or canned. The next thing we like to see you eating is whole grain products. These are going to be items like whole wheat breads, pastas, cereals, things like that. And about 6 ounces a day is what you will need. The next item on the list are foods that are rich in calcium. Calcium is very important in the healing process, especially with a joint replacement. Foods that are high in calcium are milk, yogurt, ice cream, and cheese. We like to see you getting a minimum of 3 cups per day of these items. And the last thing that is very important in your healing process is protein. Protein is what's going to help your incision to heal. These are going to be your lean cuts of meats, dried beans such as pinto beans, nuts, and my favorite, peanut butter. 5 to 6 ounces per day gives you adequate protein for the healing process.
Hello. My name is Vicki Langdon. I'm one of the registered respiratory therapists at CRMC. One of my jobs is to make sure, to the best of my ability, to make sure that you don't have pneumonia after surgery. So if you've ever had surgery before, you may have had to use one of these lung exercisers called an incentive spirometer. There is a right way and a wrong way to do it, so I'm going to show you how to do it. The therapist will come around and ask you to try and do this every hour, about 8 to 10 breaths each time you use it. We'll get your family members involved and so they can help when the therapist is not able to come around. But basically, you're going to want to take a slow, deep breath in. We ask you to make sure you take a slow, deep breath because if you don't, that causes a resistance to airflow and it makes it a little harder for you to breathe and is not the best way to do it. So I like to tell my patients, don't breathe like somebody scared you half to death. So there's two things that you're going to look at when you're using the incentive spirometer. And this, there's a little white disc that moves up and down. There's a little round disc that we're going to ask you to look at as you take a deep breath in. And the top of that little round disc should move up to the yellow marker where we have it set. The other thing that you'll look at is on the other side, and it's this yellow thing right here that moves up and down as you breathe in. and I'm going to demonstrate the wrong way to do it, and I want you to watch the yellow side. This is the wrong way. The right way to do it is you can watch the yellow thing stay kind of down toward the bottom where it says best or better or good. Either one of those would be acceptable. So I'm going to do it the right way. And then I take it out of my mouth and release that breath all the way to the end. Take a few easy breaths in between each big breath. The other thing, as you breathe in, you'll watch the white round disc. And the top of that white round disc will reach the yellow mark where we will set that for you. Watch again. And exhale completely. That's the right way to do it. We'll ask you to do 8 to 10 breaths each time you use it. And the first 24 hours is very important because you're going to have pain medicine on board. You won't be getting out of bed. So be very diligent and try to use this every hour. And as I said, we'll ask the family members to help you as well. And thank you so much. Thank you for choosing CRMC.
My name is Stacy Joyner. I'm a case manager here at Coleman Regional. The role of the case manager after your joint surgery is to assist you with a discharge plan. If you have had a total joint with a knee or a hip, you will need to have a safe discharge plan in place that may involve an inpatient skilled nursing stay or home with home health. Your physical therapist will make a recommendation after your surgery as to which rehab plan you need. Our job as a case manager is to assist you in choosing a facility and applying to your insurance company for your stay to be approved. Your physician may make a recommendation as to which inpatient rehab or home health agency you choose. We will provide you with a service directory, and it's your choice as to which inpatient rehab or home health you choose at discharge. You may have had a past stay at an inpatient rehab or have family or friends that have used a home health agency before, and we will make a referral to the agency or facility of your choice. Physical therapy will recommend to you if you need any durable medical equipment when you go home. Most knees or hips require a walker, and some also require a bedside commode. This referral will be placed to the agency of your choice and delivered either to your home or to the hospital room. In the service directory that's provided to you are a list of durable medical equipment companies that service the Coleman area. It's your choice which agency the referral is placed to. It's also a recommendation that you clear your home of any scatter rugs or small area rugs that your walker or cane or other assistive device could catch on, causing you to trip and fall at home. Most traditional Medicare plans will cover a 21-day rehab stay at a skilled nursing facility if that is the physical therapist's recommendation for your discharge plan. The first day you arrive at the skilled nursing facility is your first day of your 21-day stay. You are not required to stay for the entire 21 days. You will need someone to stay with you for at least 2 weeks, 7 days a week, for 24 hours a day if you go directly home. If you go to skilled nursing facility, the skilled nursing facility will arrange for you to have home health at discharge if your physician recommends you continue to have home health after your skilled nursing stay.
Hello, my name is Teresa Hill, and I'm one of the therapists with the hospital's home care agency, CRMC Home Healthcare. I'm going to talk to you about the therapy that you're going to have in your home after you leave the hospital. Typically, after a total knee replacement or a total hip replacement, you'll have therapy in your home 3 to 5 times a week for 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, it's easier to get in and out of your house and in and out of your car, and we usually transition you to outpatient therapy. You don't have to do anything to set up your home care. A case manager from the hospital will come visit you in your hospital room after your surgery. and she'll set up the home care for you. Then the home care agency will call you at home and make an appointment to come out to your house. You will have received a handout about the exercises that you're going to do in therapy. And I would like for you to glance at the last couple of pages before your surgery because it will prepare you for some things to expect at home, such as you will be using a walker for a few days. So just make sure you've got a pathway through the house that the walker will go. If there's throw rugs where you're typically going to walk, we ask that you take those up temporarily because they can roll up under your walker and be a fall hazard. If you're having hip replacement surgery, you may have hip precautions that you'll have to follow for about 6 to 8 weeks. And that will be things such as not bending over at the hip to pick up things from the floor, put on your socks or shoes, don't cross your legs, don't cross your ankles. Don't get excited about those precautions. They're just temporary to allow for healing. And if you have hip precautions, an occupational therapist will come visit in your hospital room to bring you some special equipment so that you can still get dressed and bathed and not violate your hip precautions. We ask that you take your pain medicine after surgery because you'll have a better overall outcome. You'll be able to do your therapy better. So don't be brave and try to go without that. You'll have a better outcome from your surgery. You have great surgeons. The therapists here in the hospital are the very best. They know exactly what needs to be done to get you up and going and ready to go home and go out in the community. So all of you should do well. Thank you.